Hi folks, and welcome to Fine Elements Pilates. Today we're going to look at intermediate air. So again, we're going to focus on lightness, following the breath, and an easy kind of flow from one thing to the next, or within the movement itself. So we're going to start as we normally do with our good posture. So standing with my feet hip distance apart. Knees are soft. Weight even on the feet and on the 3 or 4 points of each foot. Finding my neutral pelvis. And then standing down through the feet, engaging those postural muscles all the way up, keeping my ribs tucked in and lengthening my spine so my hands are nice and tall. And then letting my shoulders and my chest relax and my shoulder blades slide back and down. Back and down together. And then let my arms hang loose by my sides. Activating my core, then drawing my belly in or lifting the pelvic floor. And breathing into the ribs, expanding as you breathe in, contracting as you breathe out. And then rotating, breathing in as you go to one side. Breathing in as you come back to the center. Breathing in as you go to the other side. Again, following the breath, breathing in. Breathing in. Breathing in. Breathing in. Nice and gentle. As light as possible, except for where the weight is. The weight is in my feet. Everything above that's trying to be nice and light. Like it's made of air, just floating. And then coming back to the center. You're going to breathe in as you bring our hands together. Breathe out as we rotate the hands around, pull the palms facing the ceiling again, and then breathe in as we reach up with the arms, trying to keep the ribs tucked in, breathing out then as the arms come down, breathing in, again, light arms, light, as they come down around. And stepping to the side. And from here, I'm going to take my right hand and push across to my left side, rotating through my hips and my legs as I go. So, breathing in, breathing in, breathing in. Arms and upper body staying light, weight sinking down into the feet. So just going as far as we comfortably go, being conscious of the knees, the calves, and letting that back heel lift if you need to. But try and keep the foot grounded so you get a little stretch through the calf. And one more time on the inside. Good. Now we're going to come in from the end and go into our roll down. So again, following breath, leaving edge. Head down, looking towards the belly button. Ribs tucked in.
And then breathing in as my head passes my hips, keeping the knees soft without letting them bend too much. Then the fingertips find the floor, and then breathing out as I begin to roll back. Breathing in as I stack my vertebrae one on top of the other. Let's try that again. Breathing out as you start, and then the head go front, looking towards the belly, keeping the core engaged. Breathing in as the head passes the hips. And tipping the floor. Breathing out good, going to come back up. So there's no big pause at the bottom or the top. Breathing in, like you're inflating the upper body, nice and tall, and then breathing in as if you're letting it deflate. And then breathing in. And then breathing out. And breathing in. And then we're going to go into the push up. And breathe out. Breathe in. This time, as I breathe out, I'm going to bring my head up and walk forward on my hands. Bring my knees down to match the leverage medium time. Bring the hands in close. Knees hip distance, core engaged, straight line from my shoulder to my hip to my knee. Breathe in. Breathe in. And then breathe in as I walk the hands back, feet to the floor. And then breathe in as I roll up. Breathe in as I come to the top. I'm going to go for 5 in total. Breathe in. Keeping that straight line again, moving your arms out wider, with the hands out wider if you need to. Coming back to a box position if you can't, to push up on your knees. And then talk through the breath again this time, breathing out. Breathing in, keeping the knees up. Breathing out, look where you're going, walk forward, knees to the floor. Breathing in, chest to the floor. Breathing out as you push back up. Breathing in as you return, hands to feet. And then breathing in as you roll up. And breathing in as you roll back up. Just going to go for 2 more. Eyes on the ball, belly up until the hands reach the floor. Then walking forwards. Get that straight line. And then walking back. Looking towards the belly button. And then rolling up again. Last time. And we're going to go all the way back up to finish out the move. Push up. We're going to walk hands in. Feet to the floor, looking towards the belly button as you roll up. Breathing in to go nice and tall. And then breathing out, going to roll down one last time, with more weight. Going to walk forward and come into the double leg kicks. Going to lie forward, knees together, feet. Interlace the fingers behind the back, keep the lips tucked in, belly button away from the floor. And then as you breathe out, if you're trying to make your arms and upper body and legs as light as you can as you lengthen them out. So, and there. You want to get them as long as you can without feeling like you're making them super heavy or breathing in, exhale, and follow my breath. So I have to, there's nowhere to rest. belly button going in, imagine an ice cube underneath the belly button. You're not putting the weight into the abdomen, you're pushing down into the floor. Keeping the weight in the hips and the ribs, and focusing on lengthening the spine, lengthening the legs, lengthening the arms, bringing the shoulder blades back in together. Last one. And you're going to sit back onto the heels. Arms by your sides and fold forward.
And breathe into the lungs. And out.
And then on the next air breath. Then you come back up into a box position. Then you go into swimming box position. As you breathe out, core engage. Again, arm and leg as wide as you can. Lift your little lift if you're able. Breathing as you return. Same on the other side. Make sure you lengthen. And again, you're making the leg and the arm as wide as you can. Focus is reading up. Here and here and here. So this is where the weight is. This is where you're trying to keep steady. And I said focus the weight. Your focus today is actually on the arm and the leg because you're trying to keep them as alive as you can. Core engaged, breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing in. Breathing in. Last one on each side. Good. And then from there, you bring this arm under. I'm going to turn onto my side. I'm going to lengthen out my legs. Palm down. And go into the banana. So as I breathe out, I am trying to lift both legs and push off my elbow, lift the upper body. Breathing in as I come back down. And again, I'm trying to lift my legs, my upper body, my arm as light as possible. Last one. And you're going to bring this leg forward and push up as you breathe out, coming up to seated. And you go into spine stretch. I'm going to bring my arms up, breathe in, and then breathe out. Head is light, everything lifts and comes over. So not putting a lot of strain into my back. Not like I'm trying to push my chest to the floor, put weight in here. I'm just going as far as I can. Keeping it all nice and light. Trying to follow the breath. Yeah. hands over this side. Come down. And same idea, palm down, core engaged, bend my arm up and make drop the top hip back, make everything as wide as I can. Last one. And then we're going to push off again with the edge, coming up into my roll up position. Core engaged, legs are nice and straight. And as I breathe out, rolling back. Again, trying to make everything nice and light. Gently reaching back. Gently rolling up. Sitting tall. And back again. Gently in the following breath, breathing in, breathing in into the tall, breathing in. Should we finish with this first? So, yeah. Good. Nice and light. And we're going to do the same thing with the lower body. So we'll lower down. Arms by your side, four engaged. If you need to bend your knees to lift them, that's fine. We're going to lift the legs up. And then as you breathe out, open up and over. Breathing in, open the legs. Breathing out as you roll down. Breathing in as you come. Yeah, trying to make the legs nice and light, the weight is in the arms. That's where you're doing the work. The legs are light, just trying to keep them nice and straight. Breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in. Breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out, breathing in. One more time. Okay, hug the knees in for a moment. And then we're going to go into the single leg stretch, so we're running half a breath for each extension or for each leg. So when you're ready, lifting your head and shoulders, where you're going, shins parallel with the floor. Opposite hand on knee, same side hand on ankle. Extend your right leg to breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in, so the weight is here in my abs, pushing my lower back into the floor. Legs are trying to stay as light as possible. Same with the arms. Hips level. unit. From there, then we're going to go into the seal. So bring your feet in together, hands come through, lifting up. So you're trying to keep your legs light in your arms. Sit up as tall as you can. To start with, let your knees fall out to the outside. When you're ready again, hip core engaged, tilt the pelvis, curve your spine, roll back, and roll up. 1, 2, 3. I'm breathing in on the way back, breathing out on the way forward because it is the harder part. I feel that I need to more engage some more for it. Last one. Good. Yeah. Lengthen out the legs. Move on to the side. Climb toward the ceiling, bring your bottom leg forward. Top leg out straight, core engaged. Building your top leg up and go into side kick seats. Again, the leg is always as wide as you can. So you're lowering and just tipping it forward. Breathing out, breathing in. Trying to keep it long without keeping it terribly tense. You lay your arm on your side, you must guide the leg with the hand. Last one. And gently relax the leg on top of the bottom leg. Let these muscles relax. So we're going to keep them light. These are still working. You're still trying to keep your weight in this leg and then shoulder and hip. Keep you grounded. But our focus is the leg that is edge, trying to keep it light. So we want it long, pointed or flexed. Where we want it light. And again, gonna lengthen the leg out. This time, gonna bring the leg forward as far as you can, keeping the spine in neutral. Last one. Good. And then we're going to slide down again. And then you can push off, not tall. On to the other side. Then you're going to the spot, hip twist. So shoulders back and down, core engaged, feet together. Drop the legs to one side. Extend. So keeping the upper body nice and tall, chest facing forward. One. Yeah, legs are as light as you can. No weight in the hands, ideally. Or very little. So you go for fun. Turn the feet to the floor, you do the side kick sequence toward the ceiling. Head resting on the arm, shoulder sits stacked, bottom leg forward, top leg out in front. Core engaged and float the leg. And again, we're going to breathe in and breathe out. Try not to whack into the floor. Tip, come on. Just taking your time, and you get that length through the leg, that lightness in the leg. And if the leg connects up into your ears, you keep thinking about that length through the spine as the last one. And then you turn your leg on top of the other leg. Breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth. And we'll lengthen it one more time. And you can have your hand in the small of your back. And then forward and to the right. Breathing in as you reach in. You may find one side easier to do this on the other. And one more two. It's getting on the easier side. Space for the thigh to move in the hip joint, but also just helps keep this area steady. And last one. And let's take a moment to leave it. And we're going to roll on to the back. And into the 100. Again, floating one leg up, core is engaged. Imprint your spine, put your other leg up. Returning the spine to neutral knees to cough two. Lifting the head and shoulders first, shoulder blades back and down. Float the arms off the floor, lengthen, squeeze, and lower as far as you feel it. Again, the legs are trying to stay light, as are the arms. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Have a little drawing weight here. Not in the arms, not in the legs. Two more breath cycles. And then breathe. Rock the hips forward and back a little bit if you have the flexibility. And then now bring the head up. Make a way to seated, and then you're going to roll back. So again, coming up to balance, toes together, knees a little bit wide, hands on the shins, shoulders back and down. Again, breathing in, right, as you go back, breathing out, trying to stay light as you come forward. So I'm not trying to ground my spine into the floor, I really don't want to feel like I'm skimming over. Last one. Excellent. And then just a little bit of stretching to finish. Holding the feet in, bringing the knees out wide, sitting up tall. Just holding here. And kind of sit tall, breathing in. And ground the outside of my legs. At the inside, breathe. So as I breathe out, I breathe in, and the inside, relax. Or you can do whatever it is. Breathe in, and then as you breathe out, and then the inside, relax, feel engaged, that's it. I'm going to straighten this leg, keep this leg in, turn my chest towards this foot, and lean towards just breathing in through the nose. And then through the mouth. Go for 3 breaths. Good. And extend the leg. Again, sit up tall, turning your chest towards the foot and moving forward. Tall, and bring the other leg out. Sit up as tall as you can, and just try to lean forward. So I'm trying to hinge from my hips rather than just bending my back and trying to stretch my hamstrings and legs. If you want to focus on the back, you can keep your hips here and fold your back forward. But ideally, you want to get past that 90 degree position first before you start to fold forward. If you have real trouble, when you're doing this, you always put your hands behind and push. You're trying to keep your back to your knees on the floor, push your hips forward. Focus on tilting down with the front, with the hips. And through the nose and then through the mouth. And we're going to lean back onto the arms a little bit, keep feet out wide, but bend the knees. I'm just going to drop them in. And last one. And then we'll go into our relaxation and body awareness. My back, arms to the ceiling. Keep your legs. Breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth.
Gently tensing your feet then your calves, thighs, hips and glutes, abs and lower back, chest and upper back, hands, arms, shoulders, squeeze and release. Breathing in through the nose and out through the mouth, and again with the feet calves, thighs, hips and glutes, abs and lower back, chest and upper back, hands, arms, shoulders, squeeze and release. Deep breath in through the nose, filling up the lungs. Holding for a moment. And release. And again, deep breath in. Holding for a moment. Seated position. Thank you very much.